Oh, there.
Thank
you. Are the tickets in your pocket?
Yeah.
All righty.
Huh?
Let's go.
You ready to go?
Hi, kids.
Hi, kids. There she is. There's Lou again.
Okay.
Huh? I didn't hear you. Oh, okay. Quick shot of the van. I got to take the telescope off so I can get the van. There it is.
Okay.
For those of you joining us here at the transportation area,
to get there, welcome aboard Marl Black. Our next scheduled stop will be the Magic Kingdom. Please sit back, relax, and enjoy your ride.
Train.
I'm ready to wait.
See we are now?
Talk.
We're at the entrance. We're on the English bus, the two-decker bus, waiting to go up Main Street.
Green Omnibus, my name is Chuck, and I'll be your host and driver. At this time, I'd like to remind everyone that this is a one-way trip down to Cinderella's Castle, and while aboard, please no smoking. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the sights and sounds. As we mostly are now, Main Street, USA. Okay, folks, as we come around the corner here, if you look to our left-hand side, you'll see the Emporium Department Store. That's where you can pick up all those gift souvenirs and knickknacks, take to the friends and relatives back home. And on our right-hand side, you'll be seeing the Main Street Confectionery.
There's the trolley car with the horse pulling it.
Check out today's special. Next to the confectionery, folks, you'll find Main Street Cinema. That's where you catch face with Mickey Mouse's first ever cinematic debut, Steamboat Willie. And coming up on the right-hand side on the corner, you'll find the Main Street Market House. That's where you can satisfy all the tobacco needs, plus pick up many of the fine jams and jellies. Some other points of interest here on Main Street, USA. If you look to our left-hand side, you'll see the Main Street Penny Arcade, which is right next to the Main Street House of Madness, which is next door to the Main Street Stationery Shop, which is across the street from the Main Street Bake Shop, which is right next door to the Main Street Ice Cream Parlor. Kind of neat how everything's named Main Street, huh?
Beautiful.
Okay,
here.
Folks, I wouldn't want you to miss anything today, since I'm such a nice guy. So if you look straight ahead, you'll see Cinderella's Castle. That's right, folks, Cinderella's Castle, towering 18 stories into the sky. And directly behind the true Cinderella's Castle, you'll find Fantasyland. Almost 20,000 leagues under the sea, Snow White's Scary Adventures, the Wild Ride of Mr. Toad, Dumbo's Flight, the Magic Party, Peter Pan's Flight, and It's a Small World. And let's not forget the carousel. Okay, coming up on our right-hand side, folks, you'll find the path leading to Tomorrowland, where you can find a Wedway People Mover, the Carousel of Progress,
they're
and the
right over here,
where?
And just in case, and I will be coming to a stop here pretty soon. If you're interested in going to Liberty Square Frontierland, take the path to the rear of the bus. And if you want to go to Adventureland, take the path to the front of the bus. Adventureland to the front, Frontierland to the rear. Make you have a pleasant day in the Magic Kingdom.
Why?
I just can't talk.
Why?
Wait a while. Hi, kids.
You gonna look up here, Gary?
How are you?
Okay,
I'll look. No,
you go on top.
Hi, Deborah.
Oh, I know you're
Oh yeah, just met some. Well, I think I got a close one of Gary. And what about? Oh, there's Gary's wife. Yeah, and Trudy.
Say hi to Glenn.
Say hi.
Say hi.
Okay.
How you doing?
How about you?
Thank you.
That is a picture of the submarine, and there's the second one. What is this called? Space Mountain? Uh-oh, says light. I don't think I can get it. I know I can't now.
Now can
That's just a vast communities develop on this once barren planet. What are those rocks? Astronaut 2300 communications network. Length of orbit.
From here, you can get a better look at
I didn't at first. You've been in it now.
Yeah.
You didn't like it?
No, it was all right.
This spectacular motion picture is presented on large screen.
That's what you and Sam ran for.
Yeah.
During the rain.
Yeah.
Yeah, we didn't get to see. Are we going to see that? Holds 50 pounds of ice. Milk doesn't sour as quick as it used to. Our dog Rover here keeps the water in the drip pan from overflowing. You know, it wasn't too long ago we had to carry water from a well. Thanks.
thanks to progress, we've got a pump right here in the kitchen. Of course, we keep a bucket of water handy to prime with. Yes, sir, we've got everything to make life easier. Mother, I was reading about a fellow named Tom Edison who's working on an idea for snap-on electric lights.
I'll believe that when I see it.
That's my wife, Sarah.
But with my new wash day marvel, it takes only 5 hours to do the wash. Imagine!
That's right, folks. Now Mother has time for recreations like...
Like canning and polishing the stove.
Okay, Mother. You just iron the wrinkles out of my shirts.
Yes, dear.
But no one can improve on nature for drying clothes. Oh, well, the cistern was low on rainwater anyway. Roper, mind your manners. You know, our home entertainment is getting better, too. Get back to your homework, son. Oh, yes, we also have this. She says A-rides are old-fashioned.
Thanks for letting me go, Papa.
Be home by 9 o'clock, daughter.
Yes, Papa.
It's hard to imagine how life could be any easier. But there's a new company working on bringing the same power that runs the trolley into folks' homes. And because those fellows are working that out, one thing is certain.
Now is the time.
Summer we've had in years. Well, we've progressed a long way since the turn of the century 20 years ago. But no one realized then that this would be the age of electricity. Everyone's using it. Farmers, factories, whole towns. With electric streetlights, we don't worry so much about the youngsters being out after dark. And what a difference in our home. We can run as many wires as we need in any direction for Mother's new electrical service. Electric sewing machine, coffee percolator, toaster, waffle iron, refrigerator. And they all go to work at the click of a switch. Lugging heavy irons from the old cook stove to an ironing board are gone forever. It's a world out there, Jane.
Well, it won't always be, Father.
Now, cut that out, Queenie. You're supposed to be man's best friend. Well, we've got indoor plumbing now. Saves a lot of water. It's autumn again, and the kids are back in school. Thank goodness. Here we are in the frantic 40s, and the music is better than ever. And it's amazing how our new kitchen wonders are helping to take over the hardware. Everything is improved. Electric range is better, refrigerators are bigger, and make lots more ice cubes. But my favorite is the electric dishwasher. Now Mother spends less time in the kitchen, and I don't have to dry the dishes anymore. Oh, I spend a lot of time here. Have to. Now the television has arrived, Grandma and Grandpa take taken over my den. Television has changed our lives. It's brought a whole new world of culture into our home.
Are you asleep, dear?
Right, sports? No doubt television will improve and the kids will learn a lot from it. Right now, my son is more interested in models. Airplane models, that is.
Yes, dear. It works.
I hear it, I hear. And so do all the neighbors. Good work, son. Sports, knock it off. How about that? My son, the engineer. Well, okay, where was I? Oh, remember back in the 20s when young people got their exercise dancing the Charleston? Well, today, our daughter Jane keeps in shape with electricity.
Babs, I'm having so much fun in my first year at college.
Jane, have you met any seniors yet?
Oh, dozens. And Saturday, I'm going to the dance with a real dreamboat.
Are you doing any of the new dances?
Oh, we still jitterbug. But I'm having some trouble with the rumba. I can't quite get the hip action. Oh, and listen, Babs.
Any more hip action and she'll disconnect something. Quiet, sports. You can never underestimate the power of a woman.
Tomorrow is still but a dream. Right here and now, you've got it made. The world's forward marching and you're in the parade. Now is the time. Now is the best time. A time of joy, of strife. There's so much cheer for me that you're here, for it's the best time of your life.
You know, this is the time of day I really love. Will you look at that sunset out there?
Just breathtaking.
Great way to end the great year.
Really? It's beautiful, but I must say, having a whole family here together on this New Year's Eve is even more beautiful.
You know, dear, I think you're right.
Well, of course she is.
You tell him, Grandma.
I mean it. We're all healthy and together, and I think we're living in a wonderful time.
Do you really feel that way?
The 80s are a wonderful time.
Well, I'm in the 80s myself. I don't squat out as a slice of life.
We have an awful lot to be thankful for.
Well, the old gal's right about that.
Grandpa, wait a minute. What about all those good old days of yours? The ones you're always raving about?
Yeah, they were good, all right. But I tell you, we had to spend quite a chunk of those good old days just taking care of essentials.
Ooh, essentials. Glad you mentioned that. It's time for me to start my New Year's Eve spectacular. Omelette superbe avec jambon.
Known in other circles as ham and eggs.
Now, don't push it, sport. As for you two, whatever happened to respect for your elders?
I always wanted the same thing when you were growing up.
Well, you two can ponder that age-old question.
You guys want to talk about
it? All passengers will fly to 95. I am the coordinator. Welcome to Mission Control, space travelers. The first part of your trip to Mars today will be directed through this room, and so will your landing when you return to Earth. As you can see on the large screen behind me, we're keeping track of things on one of our many manned space stations now in orbit, while the small screens below show other activities being monitored by Mission Control. I'll have them repeated on the upper screens for you also.
SSL, this is Rotation.
Roger. SBO.
Now on the large screen again, you see a sign as to board the space station at the controls of a large telescope trained on the sun. This kind of solar research was begun back in the early 1970s by the Skylab astronauts. And time-lapse pictures from space like this are revealing new facts about how the sun produces energy, which may help us solve some of our own energy problems on Earth. This is a very interesting part of the station, where special manufacturing processes are carried out under weightless conditions. Here you see a close-up picture of a groove being melted. plate. Done in zero-G conditions, this imparts a quality to the metal we can't get under Earth gravity. Now, through an onboard microscope and time-lapse camera, we can see the way crystals form in zero-G. These space-growing crystals are so pure that they're going to bring revolutionary advances in electronics, which will benefit every one of us. In fact, they're so...
Attention!
Those small unmanned rocket ships you see here will shortly be sending back television pictures as they fly near the surface, but we'll continue our view from orbit also. Through telescopic lenses, Mars looks even more barren, and there's definitely no sign of it being inhabited. As we know now, some things once thought to exist on Mars turned out to be only illusions, such as the famous Martian canals. But it does have some natural features that are almost as amazing. For example, this gigantic rift in Mars' surface called Mariner Valley. It's over 3,000 miles long, 10 times bigger than the Grand Canyon back home. And for a planet that's only half the size of Earth, that's pretty impressive. This superimposed outline of the United States will give you an idea of its size. Here's a closer view of the section of the rift one of our camera craft is approaching. In a few seconds, we'll have the picture it's sending back, so watch the side screen, please. There's the picture. Our camera ship is down in the rift now. Seeing this close, it looks quite Earth-like, but it's hard to get the scale of things. The wall there is almost 4 miles high, and the floor is about 50 miles across at this point. Even though the branch canyons you see are 6 or 7 miles wide and go back as much as 100 miles from the main rift, this is no real canal by any means. On the upper screen, we're switching to what is literally the high point of Mars, Olympus Mons, the biggest volcano in the whole universe, as far as we know now. It's 370 miles wide at the base and over 75,000 feet high at the top. 2.5 times more than Mount Everest, the highest point on Earth. Now on the side screen is the picture from our other ship as it approaches the top of the cone. In just a moment, it will drop down into the caldera, and you can see how big it really is. On Earth, the largest calderas are up to 10 miles across, but that's 40 miles to the opposite rim. Olympus appears to be extinct now, but just imagine what it was like when that entire area was a sea.
say?
Washington, D.C.
Oh, hi, D.C. You're all in the movies now. Yell up to Gary to wave.
This is one thing you can get, a peace and quiet up here, you know?
Gary! Gary! Wave!
All right, look to the side. Move to the side, Liz,
I'd like to move over here.
Well, you got me.
Yeah, now, is that better? I was squashing Jason.
Yeah, okay, now I got him. Oh, boy, I'm right in the sun here.
This is nice and quiet up here.
Yeah.
I got through this to that girl, and I fell. I just kept going and going. I like this one.
I wish it was rocking.
Huh?
You like this one?
Did you like the airplane
ride? Yes, but when I got too high, my ears
did that. All you had to do was chew down or go. That's good. The best thing about this, even though he's got it sitting on his shoulder, he's always got his thumb going what he wants to see, yeah. You know.
Chuck, here we go.
Oh, now you can see where their garage is at, our workplace. See you guys, Lisa? Where they do all their work and stuff?
Where's Dumbo? Where's
Dumbo? Oh, here's the submarines. We didn't get on. I'll hang on to your belt. I haven't been on that submarine yet. Oh, really? Those don't submerge at all, do they?
No.
Oh, really?
Gary carrying her.
Sorry, folks. Goldberg, just play something. Anything. Ladies and gentlemen, Bunny, Bubbles, and Eula.
I'll walk down the lane,
down the lane,
parking lot. And I'm standing on top of my camper. This way. There you go. Get out of the way.
But I tell you, you come back. I mean, I would be good.
Yeah, but you weren't wearing it after that.
Thank you. catch you in a movie. Yeah.
We sat here for probably 10 to 15 minutes. We sat here 20 hours. I knew their coloring came from what they ate. Yeah. Their coloring comes from your food. I don't know what they would do. Aren't they silly that once they have?
Are you in there?
I'll get somebody else.
Tell Jason to grab his hand. Tell Jason to grab his hand.
Jason. Oh, get Deborah.
Tell Mickey to look.
Get Deborah. Deborah, give Mickey a kiss.
Come here,
kids. Give him a kiss.
Give me your hand.
Thank you. Over there with Dopey.
Pluto.
Right here. With Pluto over there. There they are. See them? Right behind.
Where's Gary at?
He's right behind him.
Nah. She doesn't want
Gary, you got your head running
can
away.
Can you get... why won't she be with them?
She's shy.
She's shy?
Oh,
I see. A small world. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well.
Clean? Well, it doesn't mean he's always taking pictures.
Yeah, we'll turn it off and on.
It's his thumb that he's moving, you know. Shuts it off and on. They sound like the school kids at home.
Okay.
Mountains of Tibet, the roof of the world, to the tropical rainforest of Guangdong.
I am Li Bai. I was a poet in the 8th century, the Tang Dynasty. But that's not important now. I've come to show you modern China. These are the grasslands of Inner Mongolia. Traditions are very strong here, such as giving passing strangers some tea. Oh, you go on ahead. I'll be right there.
Traveled all over China, and everywhere one sees our history. Begun 24 centuries ago, the Great Wall once stretched like a dragon across the northern border of China. Now, like many other historical treasures, it is one of China's legacies of the past. centuries, this dangerous intersection of three rivers has been guarded by a silent stone sentinel, giant Buddha of Leshan. China also has a living legacy of her past, a classic thinking art. Beijing is perhaps the greatest legacy of China's imperial past, the Forbidden City. For over 500 years, it was the center of the earth, and no one entered without the permission of the emperor. Since the declaration of the People's Republic, the Forbidden City is no longer forbidden. Sons of Heaven rule from the Dragon Throne. When I first came here, I was overwhelmed by its sheer size. Today, it still has the power to harm. During the European Renaissance, the emperors of the Ming Dynasty built this walled city of 6 palaces and 9,000 rooms. How dramatic that moment must have been when the Kowloon people first entered these once hallowed grounds. Gone are the landlords, warlords, and emperors. It is now a special place for all the Chinese.
Recorded in this fashion. However, it may be said that the history of the Chinese people is not written in ink, but with water.
Looking back,
water, at times too much and sometimes not enough. It has been China's sorrow for ages. Live and work one-tenth of the population of the world. They are no longer the servants of water, but its master. City sits on the Grand Canal, the largest man-made waterway in the world. Many travelers have passed this way. Marco Polo, for example, he once called Suzhou the Venice of the East.
I suppose if I had traveled to Europe,
is one of the world's greatest cities, Shanghai. Its European influence is unmistakable, but
its vitality. First made the difficult climb to the top of Huangsha during the Tang Dynasty. It hasn't changed. The formations, the solitude, the weather, all are distant lands. In the far northeast, there is Heilongjiang. Winter here can last 6 months. Where others might curse the climate, these people celebrate. Xilin Stone Forest is one of the unique works of nature. Here, too, is the homeland of one of China's national minorities, the Yi people. Its capital, Urumqi, Tibetan life. This 17th century of the world, an altitude of 12,000 feet, the people endure a harsh lifestyle with determination and courage. Jia Yuguan in Gansu province was once a way station on the ancient Silk Road. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Out here in the Gobi Desert, one also finds the Dragon's Head lies thousands of miles to the east at Shanghai Guan, where it drinks from the Bohai Sea.
The cave. The same forces that shaped these pillars of stone have done a more remarkable job directly above us.
The landscape of Guilin is unsurpassed in all of China, indeed, all the world. The unusual hills are limestone formations called karst. They were thrust upward, whatever their origin. For centuries, they have been the subject of countless artists and poets, like myself.
glance like a silver snake through scattered dragon's teeth. Whoever looks on this loses himself in eternity. Floating clouds, we drift apart. The sun.
Thank you. counties today, London.
I was going to tell him something about this song in London Town. It was a building song.
I will. I've got a lovely bunch of coconuts. Why are they all standing in a row?
I don't know them.
Well, they're big ones.
They're small ones. This song is big as your head.
Go ahead.
Give them a twist, a flick of the wrist. That's what the showman said.
Oh, I've got a lovely bunch of coconuts. I really do.
You really know what you like.
Let's dance the white, the idol, and we like singing.
Thank you.
what's in front of me.
Thank you.
American country. Later on in the song, we're going to have a roll call of the states, give you a chance to cheer for the state you love the most. Now, what that means is if you don't like the state you're from, you're welcome to pick another one. Here's how the song starts out.
Thank you.
steered in the right direction, even though he really did it. You know, use the reverse psychology on it. And it surprised him a little bit.
Your theater presentation, we kindly request there please be no videotaping. Flash photography.
I'm going to put you away.
Huh?
I'm making you go away.
Oh, bye.
Bye.
Of you have ever wanted to become space travelers. Well, here's your chance. With the help of your imagination, we're going to travel to the far reaches of the galaxy. Our destination? The planet Imaginus. Ready? Here we go. Where'd they go? Before we start exploring the planet, we'd best get used to the low gravity. We've got to try to stick together. Let's try jumping in time. One, two, three!
Run in place
until I say stop!